Hey folks, did you saw that presentation about new Apple Mac computers? Insane, right? I just tested my Hackintosh with i9 and compared Geekbench tests with MacBook Air, and that's crazy. Geekbench tests are crazy. My 16-inch MacBook Pro is a total loser comparing with Geekbench tests, and this i9 barely can compare with funless, small and light MacBook Air. So, interesting. So let's talk about, is it time to upgrade? For myself, I will say I'm going to get one. I really like this 13-inch form factor. I used 16-inch for a while and I not really like how big it is when you carry it around. But let's talk about why not buy and why to buy this new M1 powered laptops. I was expected that we maybe will see increasement in performance and battery life, but we got both. So seems that instant buy, but not really, maybe not for all of us. There is clear limitations. Firstly, there is just 16 gigabytes of RAM available right now for those new laptops and Mac Mini as well, and up to 2 terabytes SSD. I guess that most of us will be fine with 2 terabytes SSD, but 16 gigabytes of RAM, that's up to you. For iOS development, I have 16 gigabytes in this 16-inch MacBook Pro. That's totally enough, that's fine. For bit more heavy tasks, video, photo editing, more RAM is better. I have 32 gigabytes of RAM in my Hackintosh. I was planning to upgrade to 64 gigs, but frankly, I do not see need for that. And in laptop, I will be fine with 16 gigabytes. Is that fine for you? You know better. Second reason to do not buy new machines, not all the software will run on those, because we don't have an Intel processor here that is M1 processor, and software should be adapted to run on this Mac. If your old applications was running just fine on your 5-year-old laptop, then you may be in trouble on this laptop. But yes, there is a solution from Apple, that is this Rosetta virtualization, and most likely most of applications will be fine, but better double check before buying. Also, macOS Big Sur, that is minimum what you can get on this machine. You can't go lower. macOS Big Sur is just released. How good or bad for you it is, again, up to you. Next point, this M1 processor. This is very new processor, and currently only baseline of products are updated. Those are cheapest machines in product lines, that is cheapest 13-inch MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, Mac Mini. Those traditionally are low-cost machines, and next wave will be way more interesting. Design of machines is exactly the same like we saw before. Sooner or later we will see design update as well. I really hope to see finally video card update, because built-in webcam is very bad and horrible resolution. So I hope that soon we will see update for design, we will see better web camera, probably we will see Face ID as well to unlock our machines, and so on. So upcoming machines will be more interesting and fun. So if you can wait, better wait and do not jump on this first wave of machines. So why to buy new M1 processor machines from Apple? There are several reasons why to do that. If you need new machine and you are looking to buy one today, so I would not buy Intel machine if you are iOS developer. If you are developing for Android or something else, look on your tools and see what will work and what will not work for you. So maybe that is not an option. If you are iOS developer like I and you need to test your iOS or iPad apps on M1 chip on Mac to see how they work, again, there is no other options. There was development kit, which was all available for limited amount of developers, but all of the rest should go and buy new Mac from the Apple, and yeah, that is the reason why I am buying. I like to try my own apps and apps which I am working as freelancer, how they work on this M1 chip. And yeah, sure, if you are Apple fanboy, there is no other choice but buy one. That is point as well. But there is clear benefits as well. This 20 hours of battery, that about like iPads. I'm looking forward to see how Final Cut Pro will work on this machine. I would like to see which one will edit videos smoother, this Hackintosh or that M1 machine. We'll see. So, and if you are looking to buy one, which machine to get? If you already have Mac which works fine and you don't really need a new Mac, just skip it and buy nothing. But if you see the reason to buy one, of course, as always, the best price performance value is Mac Mini from laptops. If you need a laptop, if you already have a desktop, you don't like to have one more desktop, and you need mobility and looking for laptop, that's up to you. Both machines are very powerful. If you like touch bar like I do, I do not mind to have it, then 13-inch MacBook Pro, of course. If you like buttons, then MacBook Air. If you like little bit lighter machine, again, MacBook Air. If it is very minor and secondary machine and you do not care so much about power but like to have funless and deadly silent machine, again, MacBook Air is good choice. But I will go with MacBook Pro because then I will have a little bit more power. If you are going to buy one, I highly suggest you to add those extra 200 or whatever dollars and get 16GB of RAM. 8GB of RAM is just not enough today. I had a previous generation Mac Mini with 8GB of RAM, that is not enough. And yeah, this new processor is a little bit different, shared memory, unified memory, name it as you like it, but RAM is RAM, and if you have 1000 tabs opened in Chrome, it will eat your memory, whatever processor you have, Intel or M1. That was about it. Let me know what you are thinking about it. Are you going to buy one machine? And if you are buying one, then which one? And yeah, there is like button next to subscribe button. Thank you for watching. See you on next one. Bye.